Okay, welcome to this electrical machine lecture. Today we are discuss electrical angle and mechanical angle. So our topic is to understand what do you mean by electrical angle. Electrical angle in case of electrical machines. It is both for machine means for the motor as well as alternator or generator. Here we have considered a figure A. In figure A, it is a two-pole machine, two-pole alternator, which we have considered over here. It is a salient pole for our simplicity. You may consider a cylindrical rotor machine also. But for our simplicity, we have taken a two-pole salient pole machine. DC excitation is given with the help of DC supply. And it creates a north pole here permanently, and here is the south pole. Because your current is unidirectional, so once you give the excitation, one side become north and second side become south. Okay, so let from this one, this axis is called as a direct axis because it passes from the center of pole. Whereas the axis in between the two consecutive poles is known as a quadrature axis. This is already shown with the help of figure. So if we lay the conductors, two conductors, because two conductor will make coil. So this is one conductor. And the second conductor, if we join together from backside, it will become a coil. It will become a coil. So this is your coil. So coil definitely contains two conductors. Here the conductor A1 and A1 dash, if we join the conductor from the end side, it become a coil. So now here in this figure, a conductor A1 occupy the position under exact center of North Pole, and A1 occupies the location under exact center of South Pole. So we can say that these two conductors are 180 degree electrical. The distance between two consecutive poles, the distance between two consecutive pole is equal to the 180 degree. So we can say that the conductor one, A1 here, conductor A2 is here. Just we have spread the stator winding. This is your stator. It carries the armature winding. Okay. And this is also your stator. Whereas this is the two poles. So these two conductors and as well as this north and south pole are 180 degree apart. So this is the 180 degree. Okay. So here it is quite clear that the mechanical angle as well as electrical angle. So these two conductors are also 180 degree electrical. This is 180 degree electrical. Okay. And this is your mechanical angle is 180 degree. So for the two-pole machine, we come to know that the electrical angle and mechanical angle is same. So here, electrical angle is equal to mechanical angle. Okay. So these are same. And these two coils, the conductor between these two coils will remain. It is the 180 degree. This is 180 degree. Electrical. This is an electrical angle. Definitely the conductors are occupies the position at 180 degree electrical. Now we will consider a four pole machine. Now in case of four pole machine, here this axis is the direct axis. The axis which is shown by the green line is the direct axis. Similarly, if you represent the line which is by blue color, it is the quadrature axis. Why it is the quadrature axis? Because it is in between the two consecutive poles, which passes from the two consecutive poles, and this axis is the quadrature axis. Whereas the axis again passes from the second pair of pole, again it is a direct axis. So this is your again direct axis. This is your again direct axis is there. So we can say that here the quadrature axis is not 90 degree as shown in figure. mechanically it is not 90 degree with respect to the figure A. In the figure B, it is quite opposite. So if you draw this figure again by spreading the these two lines, so how we are going to calculate, how we are going to understand, say this is our stator. And this is your poles. Just a minute. This is your north pole, and this is your south pole. Okay. Now we are placing the conductor as it is. This is the one conductor occupies under the exact north pole. A1 and consecutive poles is the south pole is A2, A1 dash is here. So we will place, this is the conductor A1. This is the conductor A1 and this is the conductor A2 is here. Now, if you look at this figure, mechanical angle between these two pole is, these two pole is only 90 degree. These two poles are at 90 degree. So we will write this mechanical angle as, this is your angle distance between these two poles is 90 degree mechanical. Okay. So this angle up to this one, it is 90 degree mechanical. Okay. So whereas the angle between these two conductor is 180 degree electrical. 180 degree electrical. Why it is 180 degree electrical? It is quite simple. When the conductors of a coil occupies the exact position under north and south pole, then they will be 180 degree electrical. Means suppose a conductor is at the starting end of north pole, the second conductor at the starting end of the south pole, then 180 degree electrical. If it is both are the conductors are at the center of north and south, again it is a 180 degree. Or some ending side of the conductor, one conductor is here, ending side of the pole S2, second conductor, then the angle between electrical angle between these two conductor will 180 degree electrical. So here it is found that the mechanical angle is 90 degree, whereas electrical angle is 180 degree. So we will have a relation electrical angle is equal to, what would be that? It is, if you want to make mechanical angle should be 180 degree, you have to multiply by 2, isn't it? Or how many poles are there? 4 poles are there. So P upon 2 into mechanical angle. So this is the relation. Now, electrical angle is 180 degree, okay? Whereas mechanical angle is 90 degree. The number of pole for this, the second machine is 4 divided by 2. So again, it comes to the 180 degree electrical. So it means that the formula for electrical angle and mechanical angle, so we can have electrical angle is equal to P by 2 into mechanical angle. So this is our important relation. This important relation, if suppose there are 8 poles are there. Suppose there is an 8 pole, I will show with a different color. Say this is I draw with this color. If suppose there are 8 poles are there, what would be their poles? So I will place one pole is here, okay, in between second pole in between this one. Okay, so this is north, then it becomes south, this is become north, this becomes south. So what is the angle between these two? The angle between these two will be 45 only. Angle between these two axes is 45, means your mechanical angle is 45. And now if the conductor, instead of this A1, I will place here, it is A1 dash. No doubt the angle between conductor A1 and A1 dash is 180 degree, because one conductor occupies, or one conductor is placed under the center of North Pole, and second conductor is placed under the center of South Pole. So the electrical angle between these two conductor is 180 degree. So from this figure, it is again remain as a 180 degree electrical. Whereas the mechanical angle is 45. So our angle, we can calculate electrical angle and mechanical angle to be same, the relation. So your electrical angle is equal to become P by 2 into mechanical angle is 45. So how many poles are there? This is one. This is your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sorry, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are 8 poles are there. So we can have, this is 8. 8 divided by 2 multiplied by 45 equals to. So again, it is 4, and 4 multiplied by this one, 45 is equal to 180 degree electrical. So we can say that our important relation for the mechanical angle and electrical angle is, electrical angle is equal to P by 2 multiplied by mechanical angle. So this is the concept of, say we can say that it is the concept of your electrical angle and mechanical angle in case of electrical machine. And this is same for the DC machine. We can apply the same fundamental for the AC machine, alternator, synchronous motor, and induction motor also, isn't it? Now we try to understand what do you mean by full pitch winding and short pitch winding. Okay, so we will have one more sheet. So now we will have full pitch winding. Full pitch winding and short pitch winding. So again, we will take one diagram for to understand. Say this is your stator, and stator carries again, for our simplicity, we will have a two pole only. this is your north pole and this is your south pole. For our simplicity, we are just omitting the representation of the DC winding. Now here a conductor, two conductors are placed to make a coil. This is one conductor and this is the second conductor. So this is your A1 and this is your A2 conductors. Okay. Now these two conductors are 180 degree. So these two conductors, this is conductor 1 and this is conductor 2. It is A1 and it is A2. And the distance between these two conductor is exactly 180 degree electrical. As already we have explained, if the conductors, if the conductors of a coil occupies identical position under north pole and south pole, then the distance between these two conductor will be 180 degree electrical. So it is a electrical angle. No doubt, if there are four number of poles are there, the angle between these two will mechanical angle will maybe 45, but electrical angle is 180 degree. So we can represent this two coils are there. This two conductors are there. This is one conductor. They are joined together. This is conductor 1, A1. This conductor 2, A2. And electrical angle is 180 degree. Okay. Now for this one, we can say that the EMF induced in one conductor, E1. EMF induced in second conductor is E2, and the total EMF is simply, it is the arithmetic sum, E is equal to E1 plus E2. Because both are in the same direction, their EMF induced, say the EMF induced is 5 volt, EMF induced is 5 volt, and there because of 180 degree electrical, we can add the EMF induced, simple arithmetic sum is there. Now, if you are placing the conductor deliberately, if you are presenting placing the conductor A2 deliberately somewhat earlier slot, okay, instead of A2, A1 is here, we will place A2 dash in such a way that, because there are number of slots are there, this is one slot, this is second slot, okay, this is, so there are number of slots are there. So we are placing the conductor in such a way that they are at a different slot instead of only 180 degree. So this is your center. And from the center, this line represents the direct axis. As already we have discussed, direct axis. And because of this one, the angle will be 180 degree. Angle will be 180 degree. This one. Okay. Now we have placed the conductor somewhat earlier. So this will not be a 180 degree. This will not be a 180 degree. And we, that type of winding is called as a short pitch winding. So here it is a short pitched winding. Short pitch winding. Okay. So in case of short pitch winding, we can represent as this is a conductor A1, this conductor is A2 dash, and here the distance is not 180 degree. Distance is not 180 degree, whereas we can written as 180 minus beta. The meaning is that it is shifted an angle beta. So we will write here, this angle is beta. So we can represent in the two conductors. This is one conductor. This would be the 180 degree, but deliberately we are placing earlier. Okay. So this is 180 degree. This is the right position. It is a 180 degree electrical. Whereas the conductor is placed one ahead, one slot ahead or two slot ahead. Therefore, it is 180 minus beta degree electrical. Okay. So this is called as a short pitch winding. Now, short pitch winding, the EMF induced, it is not a simple additive because this is the e1 because of conductor e1 dash, it should be a e2 here, but because of a shifted angle, we can represent this is your a2, sorry, e2, and the vector addition is e, and definitely the vector addition will not be equal to the this e. So here e is the vector addition. So vector addition e dash e is equal to e1 vector addition of with e2. So here we can say that your e is somewhat greater than e dash, and therefore the factor come, it is called as a pitch factor. So it is represented by Kp, which is the ratio of EMF induced in full pitch winding. So ratio of EMF induced in short pitch winding. So we can say that EMF in short pitch winding divided by EMF in full pitch winding. So definitely the value of Kp, that is a pitch factor, it is always less than 1. So it may be a 0.8, 0.98, or it may be a 0.77, whatever it may, because it depend upon the shifting angle. Okay, so this is the meaning of full pitch winding and short pitch winding. But what is the advantage of short pitch winding? The short pitch winding is used to save the copper because it reduces the link copper, and it is not only for the copper saving, but it is useful to generate the sinusoidal waveform. It reduces the harmonic generation in the generator. So the third harmonic, fifth harmonic, seventh harmonic can be reduces with the help of short pitch winding. And short pitch winding is used only for separation or for reduction of the harmonic production in the system. So this is the, say, somewhat about your mechanical angle and electrical angle, relation between mechanical angle and relation and electrical angle. Second is the, what do you mean by full pitch winding and short pitch winding. So in full pitch winding, the conductors are placed 180 degree electrical, one conductor under the north pole and second conductor under the south pole. This is one thing. Second, the short pitch winding, the short pitch one more thing which we have related with the full pitch winding. In full pitch winding, the EMF induced is a simple arithmetic sum, and whereas in the short pitch winding, the conductors of a coil are placed, it is placed deliberately some angle ahead with the 180 degree, and therefore the angle is 180 minus beta, where beta is the shorted angle. It may be a single slot, it may be a two slot. The slot angle alpha is called as a slot angle. Slot angle. And beta is equal to alpha, means it is shorted by one slot. Okay. One slot only. Whereas it may be twice alpha, it means it is shorted by two slots. Okay. So your angle beta is depend upon how many slots it is shorted. So it is not 180 degree. Therefore, we have to take the vector addition, and vector addition is definitely smaller than the arithmetic addition. So one factor comes, that is called as a pitch factor. Okay. So this is the things which is related to the full pitch winding and short pitch winding. Now, what is the angle alpha? Alpha is the angle, slot angle. Say, suppose, for example, there are some slots are here over the periphery of armature. Say, for example, there are total 36 slots are there. Slots are, how many slots? The slots is 36. So what would be the slot angle? So total angle is 360 degree. So 360 divided by 36 is equal to 10 degree mechanical. So this angle is always मैकेनिकल, बिकॉज यू आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट 360 डिवाइडेड बाय 36 नंबर ऑफ स्लॉट्स आर देयर, सो इट इज अ मैकेनिकल एंगल. यू हैव टू कन्वर्ट इनटू द इलेक्ट्रिकल एंगल. सो इलेक्ट्रिकल एंगल इज इक्वल टू पी बाय 2 इनटू 10. इफ देयर आर 4 नंबर ऑफ पोल देन इट विल बी अ 20 डिग्री, इफ इट इज अ 2 नंबर ऑफ पोल इट इज अ 10 डिग्री. सो डिपेंड अपॉन द नंबर ऑफ पोल द स्लॉट एंगल इज गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट इन इलेक्ट्रिकल डिग्री. ओके, सो स्लॉट एंगल is nothing but the 360, there are total number of slots over the periphery of armature, and slot angle is equal to 360, this is 360 divided by number of slots. So now I will, if you have any doubt we can do, or otherwise we will stop here. Next time we will take the armature windings, so distributed armature windings.